Hello. Again, another day, a little bit of sorting, a little bit of resting, a lot of reaching up above the cupboards that are up there, around above the windows of the kitchen. You can almost see, yeah, there, see, that's the beginning of one. And they wrap around there and around this window and back around there, and there's like 15 foot of cabinets way up in the air. And my sister and I went through, going through a little more than half of them, first one side, then the other, and taking out all kinds of stuff. Like, here's a Stein, some people dancing, and it has something written. I guess it's German. And something written on the other side. And that's up there. And then there's this Stein from Alaska to celebrate the centennial of the territory purchase. Centennial. 1867 and 1967, Alaska purchase. This is technically a Stein. It's big enough to be a Stein. But I think the best one is not this deep frying thermometer, which you drop down into a vat of bubbling oil. Is it hot enough to pour out over the front door on the salespeople? No. I wanted to show you the other Stein. Yes. Oh. Oh, yes. This one's all pretty and blue and full of colors. And I guess it's got German on it, too. Nice handle that's made to look like some sort of wood or something. And it's amazing how they got into this whole custom of making steins. But I think my favorite one is this one. This is the Gertrude Stein. And look, I guess this is Alice B. Toklas sitting up on the back of her head. And the Gertrude Stein.
Luke, I am your father. Luke, I am your father.
No! Let's try another one. Where did I put that other one? Let's see. This is unbelievably gorgeous, but it's just a big piece of colored glass. It's just a big piece of colored glass.
I am your vase.
Well, that's what I'm up to today. Same as almost every day, my sister, maybe sometimes my sister and my brother come over. And we go through things. You got one, two, three, four, five. Five double sets of cabinets. Now they're little cabinets, they're only this high. We had to be careful getting this one out. I had to tilt it because it wouldn't come straight out. It's just taller than the door, but not as
tall as the cabinet.
You can see over there, cabinet's about that high. You see, here's the bottom of it right there, and it goes up to the ceiling, down about that far. So this, don't hold it out, you'll drop it. This is about as big as, it gets. Anyhow, I gotta put this back in the corner. We have so much stuff here. And week after week, we're going through it and sending some of it out to the secondhand shops. We had a guy here last week. Yeah, because today's Sunday, so the week is ended. Just this last week, 6 days ago on Monday, tomorrow it'll be a full week since he was here, a guy from a bookstore came and took like 5 boxes of books. He picked out from the different bookcases around the house, he picked out little piles of books he was interested in. And then we went and looked at them. And there was only one book we held back. That was a book about Yosemite that was signed by the author and was a gift to my sister's grandmother, like 80 years ago, from the author. Or I'm exaggerating, but my sister was my stepsister, which explains why I didn't know nothing about the book, because I wasn't in her family back then. Anyhow, she, oh, poor thing, she acted so ashamed that she would hold back on a book. And the guy paid $300-some for the books. Now, this is a long process. It's now been a year and a half since my mom died, and we had a funeral and burial at the military cemetery. And we're not even halfway through the process. We sort of stalled on it for almost a year, although I was going through photos and papers and such. But now we're starting to move a little more on the furniture and deciding what to do with what, and whose piece is what, and what goes where. And it's a long process, and we're lucky we have a few months to do it in. I have set February 29th as the day I'm moving out. And that's, unless I can live here, I'll be leaving on February 29th. And I'd rather live here, but I can't afford it. It's a big house. And if you've seen my videos before, you know the view out there across the street into the hills. You can see into the hills. Trees are in the way a little bit. And out that way, to the west, you can see into Freeway Valley and beautiful view. Over half the year, you can see the sunset. Going down into the distant hills. Anyhow, that's about how it is going these days. I'm going to go to Disneyland next week. And I'll tell you about that after I go there. But for now, I've talked enough, and it's now we're in the 9 minutes, over 9 minutes, getting up towards 9 and a half, so I'm going to stop at 10 or about there. And thank you guys again for listening to the old guy talking about his life, and I wish you the best. God bless you all.